Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. Today we are going to continue with our Python playlist where we are building all these different projects. In this video, we are going to show you how to build rock, paper, scissors game using Python. So the final output going to be look something like this. So here we have our user images and then the computer image. And you have these three buttons of rock, paper, scissor. So when you press rock,
yes, I win.
And computer given scissor. So it is you who is winning. So a voiceover is also there which will tell, yes, yes, I win. Next, let's give paper.
Yes, I win.
Second, you won.
Ooh, computer wins.
And whenever computer is winning, it's going to be a woo, computer wins.
Ooh, computer wins. Yes, yes, I win. Ooh, computer wins. Yes, yes, I win. It's a tie.
And whenever it is a tie, so like you have also given scissor and computer is also given scissor, so that time it is a tie. So it's going to be it's a tie. So that kind of voiceover is also there, and you can always reset this. You can, you know, start playing it all over again.
It's a tie.
So again, it's a tie.
Ooh, computer wins. It's a tie.
So this is what we are going to build. An entire source code that I am showing on this video will be available on our GitHub account. So this link I am going to provide right in our channel description. So let's dive in into our video. Now before I start, I want to request you, please do like, share and subscribe. That will really motivate me to make more this similar kind of videos, and it's going to also help YouTube algorithm to share this video with many viewers like you. So let's invoke our PyCharm. So on my previous videos, I have showed you how to build a resume builder. So the final resume going to be look something like this. Let's focus on rock, paper, scissor game. So first go to file and click on new project and give a project name as rock, paper, scissor game, and select this create a welcome script. And as promised on my previous videos, so we are going to use this UI Python package manager. So if you are new to UI, you can always watch this video. So UI is pretty much similar to the npm version that we have on JavaScript. So similar to that for Python also, now we have UI. So with the help of UI, you will be able to install any Python packages in a blazing speed. And it also helps to manage our Python projects. Alright, so if you want to learn more about this, you can always watch this video. So now let's keep everything as default and just simply click on create new window. So first, what I'm going to do is I'm going to build a very simpler version using command prompt, and then I'm going to convert that same business logic to a GUI application. And entire source code what I am going to show you on this video will be available to our GitHub account. So you can check out to our GitHub account. So this link and our article link, everything I'm going to provide right in our channel description. Alright, so let's wipe out everything and start writing our code. So let's first import random. So this random module is used to allow computer to make a random selection of this rock, paper, scissor, whichever computer wants, because we are going to build a game. For that we'll need two players, right? So one of the player will be you and another player will be computer, and whatever computer plays, so that will get decided by this random module. Alright, so next create our option array, and that will be this rock, paper, scissor. So this is the list of all valid choices that we are going to have. Next, create a dictionary of win conditions. So here we are going to define the winning ways. So when it is rock versus scissor, then it's going to be rock, and similar way when it is between paper and rock, it will be paper going to win. And finally, for scissor and paper also, it's going to be scissor will be winning against paper. Now comes the heart of our program. So that is this play game. So let's create a function called play game. I'll give a underscore, and we're going to create a loop, basically infinite loop. So until user types the letter Q, till that point it's going to continue. So let's define that. Choose rock, paper or scissor, and then in bracket you can write or Q to quit. Alright, and we are going to convert whatever user is typing to a lowercase so that we can easily use a condition to check the user input. Alright, now let's write a code to terminate our while loop. So user when equal to Q, we're going to just simply print some user friendly message like thanks for playing, and we are going to just simply break out from the loop. Alright, so I just missed a semicolon over here. And also, if user is typing some invalid options, then we are going to just simply print not a valid choice, try again, and we are just simply going to continue with that. So if user is typing anything apart from rock, paper or scissor or Q, then that's going to be simply an invalid option. So that is what basically we are checking through this option list that we have created, rock, paper, scissor. Right, so these two are our primary terminary conditions, and let's also take user input of computer, not user input, just a computer input. So random.choice options, so within these options computer going to choose, so rock, paper, scissor, and that we are taking on this computer variable, and here we are taking the user on our user variable. Now let's also print what computer is choosing and also what you are choosing. So print user choose the value. Alright, so this is just to display. Now comes the main business logic. So here we are going to compare what computer is actually giving with user. So if it get matched, then it's a tie. So if computer is giving rock and you are also giving rock, so that's a tie. So that is what we are going to show. It's a tie. Similarly, let's write the elif condition. So else if, when computer gets compared with the win condition of user, so let's say when computer is giving rock and that and you are giving paper, so when that gets compared, is user that is winning. So that's why print, it's a you win. Alright, so that is basically user is winning. Similarly, let's write the else statement. So it will be computer wins. So anything other than that, it will be computer who is winning. So yeah, basically these three conditions. One is when both the input gets matched, so then it's a tie, or else when you are comparing with computer's input with the winning conditions dictionary that you have created. So let's say when computer is giving paper and user is giving scissor, so it's the user scissor that is gets win. So that's what we are printing over here, or else anything other than these two conditions, it will be always computer who is winning. Alright, so now let's just simply call the heart of our program, that is this play game function. So just simply call that, and this is our code basically. Just simply click on the run button after that, and there you go, it's going to immediately start building and going to show you the output. Alright, so here let's start with our first condition, that is Q. So if user is typing Q and just simply hit enter, it will immediately terminate by telling thank you for playing, and it is terminated, right? Gracefully terminated. So let's rerun it again, and this time give some random input which is not within our option array. So just hit enter and it's going to tell you this is not a valid choice, please try again. So you can see this time our loop is not getting terminated, it's still active and it is again asking for your choice. So this time let's give a valid choice. So let's say rock, and there you go. So you can see computer also chooses rock, he also chooses rock, so it's a tie. So let's give paper, click enter, and this time you can see computer chooses still rock, and this time you have chosen paper, so you are winning, right? So let's give scissor and hit enter, and this time again it's a tie. So that's just a very simple rock paper scissor game developed in a command prompt. So let's enhance this and create a GUI version of this. Alright, so for that you need to install a couple of Python packages. So go to terminal and just simply install UV pip install pygame and hit enter. So that will immediately start downloading our Pygame. You can see how lighting first it is, right? So only time it's going to take is to download. Apart from that, installing is really quick using UV. So that is what I was talking when I was creating this project. You can see it's rightly installed. So next, quickly jump over to our GitHub account. So here you will get two Python files. One is this main.python, which is what we have just now created, this command prompt version of rock paper scissor game, and this time let's create a GUI version of the same thing. So just open this GUI version and I'm going to copy this entire source code and I'm going to just paste it over here. All right so there's one more package that we need to also install, that is PIL. So also type UV pip install pillow. Alright, so because we are also going to show the images of both user and robot, so that's why we need PIL as well. So that is also installed now. So now let's terminate the old program, and this is our latest code. And let's also add a couple of items, such as an image of a computer robot. So I have already shared some of the GIF on our GitHub repository. So if you want, you can always use all this, or if you simply want to use something from your end, so that also you can do. Alright, so you need to just replace this image, and we have also added some audio. So it's going to play a voice over when you are winning, or if it is a tie, it's going to love, or else when computer is winning, so there will be a boo. Alright, so everything I'm going to show you. So here are all those elements. So let's copy it and put that to our project. So these are all projects that I have been creating recently. So let's go inside our project and paste all these items. Alright. So now when we click on run button, you can see that our project is rightly opened over here. So let's start playing. So when we click on rock,
yes, I win.
You can see when user, that is me, is winning, you are going to get a voiceover that yes, I win. So let's play paper.
Ooh, computer wins.
You can get the voiceover right when computer wins.
Yes, I win.
So this time I am winning.
Ooh, computer wins. Ooh, computer wins. Yes, I win. Ooh, computer wins. It's a tie.
So whenever there is a tie, there is a laughing sound and it's a tie.
Yes, I win. It's a tie.
You can also get the game history that are listing over here along with the scorecard. and the profile images of your user and the computer, the robot with whom you are playing. This is a funny game that I've just developed. If you want to use this, you can use this entire source code. It is, you know, open source, so you can use it, you can modify it, you can add this project to your resume as well, and you can also share this project with your friends as well. Alright, so in my next video, what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how to create a exe version of this entire project. So what it's going to be is it's going to be just a exe. So on double clicking on that, it's going to open this and playing this game. Alright, so you don't need to jump over to PyCharm to run this project and play this game. Alright, it's going to be just a exe. So just double clicking on that exe, it's going to immediately start opening the game console and you can start playing. So how we do that, how we generate a exe from this type of GUI project is what I'm going to show you on my next video. So keep watching our tutorials and also do watch our other videos that are there on this cool Python project playlist. I am sure you are going to love it. So some of these projects are really interesting, you know. So one of them is the very first one that I have created. So this is this turning a text into a realistic speech.
How realistic it is, right? And you can see how realistic it is, right?
It's really a very real. It's very realistic, isn't it? So it also supports all regional languages along with the accent as well with respect to region. So this HTTPS Python library is what I have used. It's really amazing. So I highly recommend you to watch all these videos on our playlist. Alright. And also if you love reading articles, then I always recommend you to follow our website Geeky Script. So here I keep on posting new articles every week. So you can always read this with a detailed description. I have, you know, written this article. So first we have, for example, if I talk about this rock, paper, scissor game. So I have explained everything along with the source code, and then you will get the full GUI code here as well along with the explanation. Alright. And lastly, special thanks to the supporters of our channel. We are truly grateful to you guys. Supports like this really motivate us to create and improving these videos. Again, thanks a lot for being an essential part of our journey. So yeah, so that's basically all about this video. Please do like, share and subscribe. That's going to really motivate me to make more and more the similar kind of videos. So that's basically all about this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.